deer hunting is a North American tradition that will last forever, right? For decades, we have enjoyed the rewards of the greatest conservation success story of the 20th century, whitetail restoration. But there are ominous trends converging, even as deer hunters celebrate success in a new millennium. Hunting access is fading from hundreds of thousands of acres each year. Deadly diseases are spreading into new areas, devastating deer numbers and depleting wildlife agency budgets. The North American model of wildlife conservation is under attack, especially the central idea that science should guide wildlife management, not politics. Hunters continue to decline as a percentage of the population. Deer habitat quality is threatened on both public and private hunting lands by overzealous environmental restrictions that prevent wise habitat management. Unfortunately, the hunting industry seems unaware or unconcerned about these threats, taking its most important species, the whitetail, for granted. There is one hunting organization actively fighting to ensure the future of our deer hunting heritage, QDMA. QDMA has launched a study in partnership with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service at a national wildlife refuge overrun by suburbia to seek ways to maintain deer hunting and healthy deer herds despite urbanization and habitat fragmentation. Our newly released documentary, Living with White-Tailed Deer, the community version, will educate non-hunting suburban residents to help maintain hunting access. Outside of suburbia, QDMA is supporting programs to connect farmers with hunters to address crop damage while giving more hunters a place to go afield. But we must do more. Increased access to public lands is not a victory if the deer habitat is poorly managed. Many public lands are dominated by mature forests with few young forests and food plots to support wildlife populations. One group is helping to correct this. QDMA. Since 2004, QDMA branches in Pennsylvania have spent more than $106,000 to plant more than 120 acres of food plots on state game lands and state forests. This year, QDMA formed three new QDM cooperatives centering on federal wildlife refuges that will drive habitat improvements on both public and private acres. And these cutting-edge projects will blaze a trail for many more cooperatives that will follow. QDMA is funding new studies that will arm all deer managers, including government agencies, with more effective guidance on the use of fire and forestry techniques to improve deer forage and cover. And QDMA's army of elite deer stewards, leaders in improving deer habitat and herds, is growing. Nearly 1,000 QDMA members have now completed an in-person deer steward course, and over 250 more have taken the online course. This last group includes soldiers stationed in combat zones who were offered free access to the online course this year. But we must do more. QDMA directed $38,000 to study factors affecting the spread of chronic wasting disease across the landscape. The first whitetail organization to join the CWD Alliance, QDMA is putting enormous staff effort into advocating effective policy with regard to both CWD and EHD. QDMA and its volunteer branches have focused educational efforts, including dozens of seminars in disease-affected areas, to better inform hunters and help management efforts. But we must do more. If science is to continue driving whitetail management, it must remain relevant. QDMA has directed more than $500,000 in the past 7 years to deer research projects in more than 20 states, and we want to double that amount much faster. In the meantime, we've kept a watchful eye on wildlife policy and legislation. Our education and outreach staff engaged 72 policy issues in 20 states and 5 Canadian provinces in 2012 alone, from the Farm Bill to the Sportsman's Heritage Act. And at the current pace, we'll spend a record level of staff time this year fighting bad deer policy and backing good deer policy. But we must do more. With an enormous boost from an initial $550,000 endowment from Midway USA, QDMA's Rack Pack Youth Initiative, launched in 2012, is already reaching thousands of young hunters and helping them become tomorrow's deer stewards. Rack Pack hunts and other events hosted by QDMA branches and the national office are happening now and planned this fall across North America. But we must do more. QDMA, with a network of volunteer branches that will reach 200 this year, is doing more. More educational events, more QDM cooperatives formed, more members recruited, and we're working to get the broader hunting industry on board. The first ever national gathering focused on management of white-tailed deer will take place in March 2014, bringing together leaders from all corners of the hunting industry. One organization saw the need for a whitetail summit and has shouldered the responsibility to organize this historic gathering, your QDMA. We are at a crossroads for deer hunting. Inaction and apathy will bring disaster, but the right choices now will ensure our tradition lives on in coming generations of deer hunters. QDMA is committed to ensuring that vision, but we must do more. Commit to QDMA, and together, we will do more.